So today's video, we're diving into the top 10 iPad productivity applications for 2021. Now this video is perfect if you're someone that's new to iPad or maybe even looking to be more productive on iPad, or you're going to college or university in the near future and you're looking for some applications to keep you organized and focused on the work ahead. So these applications have been handpicked by myself and I think you'll love them all. Today's video is sponsored by Muse. Now Muse is a spatial canvas for visual thinkers. We've done a review on Keep Productive about Muse, and since then they've added a range of features. Muse is a little bit different because what it does is it's more spatial and freeform, allowing you to be a visual thinker, organizing everything, and perfect for that creative process, even if it gets a little bit messy. It's also got a powerful interface that allows you to use both hands on the iPad and even the Apple Pencil. They've got a range of interactions that you can actually find in the interface handbook, which I'll link below. And also it's perfect for doing things like reading and understanding academic papers. So it's a perfect place for being able to coordinate things visually, and the application, it will be available in the description below. It's fantastic to have Muse over here on the channel. So let's dive into the recommended apps that I've pulled together. So number one is 1Password. Now 1Password is a password manager, and I never used to use a password manager, but I got this downloaded a couple of years ago and now I'm starting to use it to save passwords, and it's definitely taking a load off my mind trying to remember long-winded passwords. This application works really well, in particular on Mac and iOS devices, so you won't be missing short on the iPad, and it's got some great security and helpful features for being able to create passwords. Number two is Agenda Notes. This is a date-focused note-taking application that has grown in popularity over the last few years because it allows you to take a note and connect it with a calendar event that you may have. Now, if people really love the fact that it's got Markdown and there's a premium that unlocks a range of things like templates, but it's a great little hub for being able to orientate your notes around dates and times that you are suitable for example, meetings, planning trips, and date associated events. Next up is ScanBot, or should I say SwiftScan. Now ScanBot, now called SwiftScan, is a way for snapping a document in a perfect quality and being able to send it on. You can turn it into a PDF, or you can convert it and send it to other devices. So for example, through AirDrop, and also you can send it to other services like Evernote, Notion, and other applications. And it's growing in popularity as a way for doing that and being able to save it in detail. Number four is Notability. Now, Notability is a great pencil-based application. It works brilliantly with Apple Pencil as a way to sketch things and go into a bit more detail with some of your revision notes. A lot of people like this because they've got a range of color options and also some great Apple Pencil abilities. They allow you to change things like the nib and really go into a great level of detail. There are some great examples of advanced Notability notes that people have taken across their day for studying, revising, and exams, and it's really very amazing to see. Number five is Craft. Now Craft is a note-taking application at heart. It allows you to create notes in Markdown, and the great thing is on the iOS devices they've built a brilliantly native application, which means that if you're an Apple user you'll love this, even though they do have a web version. Now Craft looks great and allows you to collaborate with others in real time if you want to, and a lot of people are using it to take notes in a more professional manner. Number six is Otter Notes. Now this isn't a note-taking application, but it is a way to be able to capture meetings and other such things that you may want to maybe transcribe across your day. For example, if you are in a Zoom meeting, you can connect up Otter and be able to get a full transcription of what everyone said during the meeting so that you can refer back to it in your notes for later. Now, Otter's accuracy when it comes to being able to organize and be able to capture everything that's being said is fantastic. And a lot of people are enjoying it for that exact reason. Number seven is Bear Notes. Now, again, another note-taking application that's gorgeously built for the iPad. It does have a great way to organize your notes in hashtag, and it's much more of a traditional note-taking application. You can add images and also utilize some of the great abilities in Markdown to make such simple and beautiful notes. So number eight is Fantastical 3. Now, this is an application that's is $39.99 per year for premium, but they do have a little bit of a free plan. But Fantastical 3 is probably one of the best built built calendar applications on the market. It allows you to connect up with apps like Todoist, and it's super easy to use. You can even connect it to things like weather, so you can get the weather as you go across your workday. Number 9 is Things 3. This is a $19.99 application, but it allows you to take some fantastic notes, organize your projects and areas alike. And a lot of people find this to-do list application one of the most minimal and gorgeous on the market. It's perfect for coordinating what you want to do ahead in your day. And if you've got a little bit of a budget on the iPad of $20 for a note-taking application, that's a one-off fee, you'll really enjoy using this to-do list application. And number 10 is Day One. Now, Day One is a journaling application. It allows you to capture images, create galleries, and also take notes from your day, a journal entry, and it works on pretty much all devices. I've actually got a friend called Robin who has been writing his Day One for like 5+ years, and he says it's a really brilliant application for being able to coordinate that side of stuff. And as you can imagine, has all the regular sort of locking features with Touch ID and things like that. So those were our 10 iPad applications. I hope you enjoyed today's video. A big thank you to Muse for coming on and sponsoring. Remember, you can check Muse out below, but they have some great abilities which I think you'll love and find really beneficial if you're a visual thinker. So folks, a huge thank you. Please do make sure to subscribe if you're brand new. We've been more recently doing a lot more writing on a platform called Medium. So if you want to check that out, we've been writing about the future of productivity software. If you want to check that out, I'll link it in the description below. And there's also our Skillshare classes as well, which covers a range of different topics, but you can get 30-day free or 14-day free. I'll link in description. And you can get access to all of the productivity classes that we have there. But a huge thank you for stopping by, folks. I really hope you enjoyed today's feature. Feel free to share some of your favorite iPad applications in the description below. Cheerio, folks, and thank you very much.